Hi, I'm Matt Buteri from Buteri's Restaurant and Bar in Richmond, Nelson. Here at our award-winning restaurant, we believe in using the best of seasonal fruits and produce. So with Fruzio Fruits, we have a great product. They come in 250 in kilogram packets. You can see what's in the bag, you can see where they're from, and they're sourced from A-grade growers throughout the world. And the good thing about them, you can use them, as I said, all year round. So when the berries aren't in season, you can just go and get a packet of Fruzio Fruits, and away you go. So the recipes that you're about to see are great little recipes. You can use any berries that you like, and they're just a base and a guideline to how you want to do things. If you are ever in Nelson, we'd love to see you at our restaurant where we can show you what we do with some of these products. Thanks. So here I've got my Fruzio's raspberries. Drop it in my super cool blender. Any blender will do. I'm just going to blitz these up. Okay, so they're blitzed, they've taken care of. Now I've got three eggs here. So the best thing with the eggs is always crack them into a different bowl than what you're putting the mix in. Just so you make sure that there's no blood, no shell. So this recipe calls for three eggs, 100 grams of caster sugar. If you find it too sweet, cut it back. I've used 100 grams of caster sugar. The acidity of the raspberries, so it gives it a nice balance. But if you like more acidity, take off the sugar. If you want it sweeter, add a bit more. But personally, I don't think it needs any more. It could actually probably do with less. So I've got three eggs, 100 grams of caster sugar. Got my lemon. I want to take my zest off my lemon, so I've got a little zester. So I want to infuse the lemon zest into the mix after it's finished. But I don't want to put it in now, because if you put it in too early, it can also make it a little bit bitter. So I'm just going to cut my lemon in half. Pour the juice into here. And on the stove, I've got a pot of water that's just simmering away. So I just want to whisk my eggs, my sugar, and my lemon juice. Just until it's lightly mixed, like so. So I've whisked my eggs, my sugar, my lemon juice. Now I'm going to add my raspberries, which are here. Look at that colour. I just want to put that into there. Then I'm going to go to the stove. I'm going to put this onto the stove on my pot of simmering water. You can do it with just in a pot without water underneath, but it's a safer way of doing it over a baby room. Before I put this in the pot, I want to have 100 grams of butter cut up, which I've done. It's in my fridge. You leave it in the fridge because you want to add cold butter to something hot so it homogenises. Right. So now, just going to mix that in. Like so. I'm just going to go and put this on the stove and I'm going to cook it out. It'll take about 10 to 12 minutes and then I'll show you what it's like. So you need a wooden spoon, take a spatula so you can keep wiping around the sides. When you're cooking it out over water, you want to make sure that you're doing it nice and slowly. The water's not boiling because you do not want it to curdle because the eggs will you'll end up with scrambled eggs. Okay, so we'll see you in 10 minutes. So here we are. I have my raspberry and lemon curd. See how thick that is? That's how you want it. So now I'm just going to put in my lemon zest. It just gives it that, you know, that kick that it needs. Also keeps it really nice and fresh. So I've got 100 grams of butter in here. Now, if you don't want dairy in it, add an extra egg yolk to the mixture and then you pretty much don't need the butter. What the butter does, it just gives it a real nice smooth and palatable finish, okay? So you want to add this, you want to leave your bowl on the water over your pot and you want to add only a couple of bits of butter at a time. Really important, because if you put too much butter in, it'll split out. So when you've worked your first few pieces of butter in, add a couple more, try not to miss the hole. Again, work it until it's amalgamated. And once you start getting once the first few pieces of butter in and it's amalgamated, then you can be a bit more generous and add a few more. So once all my butter's gone into the dish, into the raspberry and lemon curd, you do want to pass it. So I've got a chinois, a small ladle, a spatula, and I'm going to push this through. I'll show you. Because it's important that the curd is smooth. You don't really want to have a whole lot of grainy bits in your raspberries. If you do, then you don't have to worry about it. You can leave it in there. There you go, you can see it dripping out. So now I'm just going to push that through. See there, if I lean it up against that, see how smooth that is. Beautiful. Once it's finished, you want to put it in the fridge as quick as you can, cover it over with a little bit of cling film, put the cling film actually on top of the curd so then you don't get a skin. Place it in your fridge and take it out when it's cold. It'll get thicker as it sets. And then you can use it breakfast, on toast, on ice creams, on muffins, anything. It can be used on anything. And here we have our finished product that I did earlier. Right, and then you can see the consistency of it. So it's not too thick. It's not runny, just perfect. Delicious. Fruity fruits all year round.